believe it's.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Can I ask the council to roll call, please?
Sure. I have Commissioner Wayne Bailey here. I have Commissioner Gonzalez.
Yes.
Commissioner Moore. Commissioner House.
Here.
Commissioner Cortez. And Commissioner Saldivar.
Here.
Commissioner Amaya.
Here.
Okay, thank you. So we wanted to begin tonight's meeting by asking each of the speakers to introduce themselves. And let us know, since you are all working artists or people who represent arts organizations, give you a chance to introduce why you are here, what work you do in your day life, and what district you represent. So I will start over on my far right, please.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Juan Carlos Gonzalez from JC. I am an artist practitioner, visual artist, and I represent Urban Arts Collaborative. Urban Arts Collaborative is located in Chinatown, at 21 Soledad Street, C6, Avenue Moongate Plaza. And we've been in existence since 2012. We are a fiscal sponsor and a project of the Action Council. I also teach at Mayo College. I teach fine arts three courses every semester. And I also participate in a local organic farm called Lindam Organics. And through that venue, I help students every semester to receive a farm license for free. They will charge for the last year and a half. And thank you.
Hello, my name is Sandra Saldivar, and I'm retired, but I'm also the director of the Salinas Valley Art Gallery in Old Town. We celebrated our 45th year last month, and I've been with the gallery over 13 years now. I design jewelry, and we do pretty good. We're surviving this pandemic. But other than that, I'm just enjoying life right now, taking it day by day.
Wonderful. As we go into the holiday season, we can go down to the gallery to go shopping, right?
Yes.
For special, unique gifts.
Yes, we will be with the Business Expo on the December 16th, and we will be having a wreath-making workshop on the 4th of December, hoping to attract people into the gallery. Plus, they get to make a wreath, so it'll be
wonderful.
Nice. Thank you.
My name is Colleen Bailey. I am, in my day job, the executive director of the Monterey Jazz Festival. I am a Salinas native and grew up here and have participated in the arts here for many, many years, and was a performing artist before I went into the nonprofit sector and an arts teacher. And I have been with this commission since it first started, so I'm one of the longer standing people on the commission, and it's wonderful to be here.
Hello, my name is Javier Tamayo, and I am currently the executive director of the LaSalle Center for the Fine Arts, and I represent District 6, and I have been a performing artist for many years, and have been working as an educator in public schools and community spaces for about approximately 20 years as well. And I'm happy to be here. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Bernice House. I am a Salinas resident for more than 10 years. I have a background in dance and performing arts. And also, I have been working for more than a decade in Monterey County as an arts administrator. When I moved to Monterey County, I was a dance teacher for creative movements at elementary school. So that was my first year in the county. And I'm happy to be here with all my colleagues, our commissioner. I'm super inspired to be surrounded of amazing people that have been helping the community for a long time.
All right, thank you. So now it's time for all of you. It's public comment time. We're restricted to 2 minutes, so if there's any member of the public who would like to come up and make a comment, you are invited to do so now. Okay, seeing none, do we have anything online? Any public comment online?
No.
Okay. All right. And I think we can go straight to the consent agenda at this point. And so hopefully everyone has had a chance to look at the minutes. And I would, if anybody has would like to approve or make a motion to approve the minutes, we can do that now if you have any comments or questions. And we'll do that after we have a first and a second.
I motion to approve.
Okay, thank you. We have a first. Do I have a second?
I second.
Okay, thank you. Any questions, comments, changes? Seeing none, I would call for the question, please.
Okay, Chair Bailey?
Aye.
Commissioner Gonzalez? Commissioner House?
Yes.
Commissioner Tamayo?
Yes.
Commissioner Saldivar?
Saldivar, yes.
Sorry, Commissioner Gonzalez?
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. And now we're very happy to welcome Erin Lyman, who is the Community Engagement Manager at the Arts Council for Monterey County, who's here to make a presentation about grants that are available to artists in this community. So, Erin, when you are ready, thank you so much for being here.
Hello, and thank you so much for having me. I appreciate you giving me the time. My name is Erin Lyman, and as Colleen mentioned, I am the Community Engagement Manager at the Arts Council for Monterey County. And the Arts Council for Monterey County has been around for 40 years this year, and we've gone through a couple name changes, so that is the correct one, but we've also shortened it now to Arts4MC, so just to help people find us a little better. And the mission of the Arts Council for Monterey County is to improve the quality of the life for everyone in our region through the arts. And one of the many things that we do is we provide enriching visual and performing arts education programs. We provide specialized arts as healing programs and funding and support for local artists, art nonprofits, and cultural organizations, which is what I'm going to be talking to further about today. We are also the state and local partner for the California Arts Council. So due to that SLP designation and also to the hard work of our directors with local foundations, we apply for and get grants that we re-grant out to all of the districts in our county. So the granting opportunities that are available in 2021 and 2022 through our platform. Start with the community arts grants. Here is a picture from Ariel Theatrical, one of our grantees. Community arts grants, they are available to Monterey County-based nonprofit organizations seeking support for public arts and culture projects and programs up to $5,000 per year. For this particular grant cycle, the maximum organizational budget is $250,000. The grant and program must be completed within Monterey County within 1 year of the grant award. Each organization can get one grant per year, and they must complete the previous grant's final report before applying for a new one. An applicant without nonprofit status, a 501c3 designation, may use a fiscal sponsor. And though you may use any fiscal sponsor that works under a 501c3 designation, we suggest use the California-based Action Council. Or, and I really want to stress this, you can collaborate with a nonprofit that can act as a fiscal sponsor. So if you are an artist or a teaching artist or a place with a venue that wants to hold an art program, you can collaborate with a nonprofit, and there are many nonprofits in our area, and then you can apply for the grant under their nonprofit status, and you would work for them as if they were your fiscal sponsor. So I'm all about collaborate and partner with those that can help make this happen. And the funding for the community arts grants is provided by the David and Lucille Packard Foundation. The review process, our grants are awarded on a first come, first serve until funds are expended. So please don't wait until the last day. And I really want to stress this, that the Arts Council appoints panels so that we are, the staff and the board are not responsible for actually the giving the money out or dividing it up. There is a panel appointed for every grant cycle with at least 5 community members that have diverse perspectives and also represent all of the county's districts to review the application so that everyone hopefully gets a fair read by having their district represented as well. The highest scoring grant applications will be complete and accurate, attaching only the required documents. So again, you don't need 12 documents that just mention you once. You only need that one that really states that you're a viable organization or you have a viable program. Also, too, the overall strength of the organization, including evidence of the community support and leadership, the quality of the program or project, including the qualifications of the personnel, the scope of service, and the potential impact on the Monterey County residents. So bonus points if you have really evidence of unique contributions to our region. The second granting process that I'm gonna talk about is our Arts and Cultural Impact Grants. And that was a Chispa Housing guitar class. Photo there. And then the Arts and Cultural Impact Grants doesn't have a budgetary limit, but it's also available to nonprofit organizations or fiscally sponsored organizations seeking support for public art and culture projects or programs up to $5,000 a year. There's 2 grant cycles for this program, spring and fall. And again, 1 grant per year per organization, and you must complete the grant's final report before submitting a new application. And the Arts and Cultural Impact Grant funding is provided by the County of Monterey. Some restrictions for the Arts and Cultural Impact is that you can work with a university or a college as a fiscal sponsor, but they can only provide 1 arts program per year, and grants may not be applied toward support of political or religious purposes, fundraisers for other organizations, capital improvements, the purchase of equipment, property, projects that are either completed, etc. So, granting can seem a little overwhelming, especially if you haven't done it before. And recently, the Arts Council moved over to a wonderful granting software called Fondant. And Fondant is great because you can create a username and password for free, and you can go in and you can save and edit and draft as many times as you need until you're ready to submit. Also, too, it shows you with red asterisks exactly what's required. So you cannot pass go, you cannot collect $200, you cannot move on to the next phase of the granting application until you complete these the red asterisks, at very least. And nothing that you wouldn't expect. Nonprofit status, they ask you about the board of directors, the scope of the program, budget explanation. All in all, it's a 3.5 page application. So not only can you start it and work on it at any time during the grant cycle, But if it's not complete, it will get sent back to you. Clara Hickmanova, who works directly with the granting, will get back to you. She'll talk you through it. We'll help you get it done. But Fondant is a beautiful new software that we're using to make it streamlined and simple and less daunting for everyone. I put it to sleep. Oh, good job, Trish. All right, another valuable resource that we've put together, many of you may know Arlene Krebs. She's worked with writing grants in our community for quite a while and was the board president for the Arts Council for many years. We have created a resource with her, a tutorial on grant writing. It's broken into three segments: a how-to, if you've maybe never written a grant before, a how to complete the Arts Council grant, specifically talking about our granting process, and then the last one, grant information, reuse, recycle, reapply. Hopefully, you'll be applying for more money. This won't be your first time. You don't have to reinvent the wheel every time. And she talks about how you can use what you've already done for your future funding requests. You can watch all three. They're on our YouTube, they're on our website, they're available to you, and they're also translated with Spanish subtitles. So, what other funding do we have that's not necessarily organization-based? We have our local emerging artists program, and that's lovingly called LEAP, and this is one of our female videographers for a couple years ago. And the local emerging artist program, emerging doesn't necessarily mean young, it just means that you're in the early stages of your career. So this program provides a financial stipend of up to $2,500 to selected artists in early stages of their career who demonstrate that this support will make a big impact on their work and on our community. We were able to give 5 stipends of $2,500 in 2021, and our next grant cycle opens in spring of 2022. So if you know any local emerging artists that have an idea that a grant could help launch them into the next phase, this would be a great grant program for them. And some other funding, again, being a state and local partner for the California Arts Council, being connected with other local funders, we do sometimes get funding that is for individual artists, for operating costs, for unrestricted funds. The Creatives Relief Fund in 2021 we were able to give that out in a couple cycles. And basically, you just had to answer yes to 4 questions. Do you live in Monterey County? Are you 21 years or older? Are you a practicing artist that's experiencing dire financial need? Yes, 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 yes. Money. It was great. And that funding was provided to us by the Community Foundation of Monterey County. And I just bring that up because, again, like our MC Gives campaign, we were able to give 2 years in a row scholarships to high schoolers who wanted to pursue arts education and their higher education. So 2 years of high school scholarships, that was great. Just stick with us. Stay in touch. If you want to learn more about our grants, you can go to our website, arts4mc.org/grants. But I would sign up for our newsletter. We do bi-weekly newsletter, and also you can follow us on social media at arts4mc. And we do give posts and updates about upcoming funding, whether it's part of our normal cycles or whether it's new and interesting funding, like I mentioned at the end. Clara Hickmanova and I are both available. Clara is the Grants and Exhibitions Coordinator. Many of you have written grants for us, and she will work with you to help get it done. And then you can always reach out to myself, Erin Lyman, the Community Manager, and those are our emails, clara@artsformc.org or erin@artsformc.org. And my goal as the community engagement manager is just to bring this knowledge to you all, and hopefully you can bring it to your communities. We know that during the last year and a half during COVID, some of the nonprofits, the arts organizations have shuttered. So we're trying to reconnect. We're trying to find people that maybe don't know about us yet, other small nonprofits or arts organizations or artists that qualify for this funding so we can get it to them. So that's it for me. If anybody has any questions, I'd be happy to answer.
I just want to thank the Arts Council for Monterey County. It's because of them I've seen many programs flourish and many kids provided with materials. So kudos, my hat goes up to the Arts Council. Thank you very much for all the support in our community.
Thank you. And hopefully we'll find more people to support. So thank you very much.
Any questions? Any questions?
Thank you so much for a great presentation and great information. Really appreciate it, Aaron. And congratulations on your new position. Okay, we have an exciting next thing, which is acceptance of an art donation on behalf of the city. So, Jose?
Yeah, so we're lucky to be joined tonight by both the Commissioner of the Art and the artist herself. And so I see we have Councilmember Steve McShane here. You see the picture we're putting up on the wall, this piece of art, which is of another famous piece of art in Salinas, the Hats in Three Stages of Landing, currently is being displayed in the John Steinbeck Library. And I'd like to invite Councilmember McShane up to say a few words, maybe the artist, if you'd like, about the piece of art, and then we'll go to consideration for the council. And while Councilmember McShane's coming up, the consideration to the council here tonight, or the commission, excuse me, is to, staff recommends that you accept the art on behalf of the city of Salinas at this time. Councilmember McShane.
Yeah, thank you very, very much, Mr. Ariola. Just delighted to be here. It's great when you see a local artist flourish. And, you know, I think one of the most exciting things that I've seen in this artist is, you know, it's later in her career that she's come into art and been recognized. And this is just such a truly exceptional project. I'm not sure if commissioners saw the program that was published, but I'll make that available to the clerk to share with the commissioners. So really just love to see this tonight, here to celebrate it, and want to thank each and every one of you for your service. So I think we need to bring the artist up when it's appropriate and hear from her and her inspiration, because this is one of the city's most valuable pieces of art that she has captured in a very unique way. So just want to say thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Councilmember. And artist Gail Tier, please join us.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Gail Tier, and I find myself happily entrenched in the art world after spending most of my life being self-employed in different forms of real estate and construction. I never thought I would do this. I've lived in Seaside, where I built my own home, since 2009, and I'm here tonight with my daughter, Sarah, who is the true artist in the family and who works in that capacity for the city of Seaside. Painting is an everyday thing for me. I try to paint a little bit of everything, but considering where we live, it's hard to ignore the local beauty. Landscapes play a large role in my catalog. My work has been featured on studio tours and was recently commissioned for custom pieces for a new whiskey bar venue in downtown Monterey. I come from a family with deep roots in painting and illustration, but it was still later in life that I discovered my own ability because of one just for fun paint and sip class. I had never done it before then. After that night, I never stopped, and I have such an inventory. I was painting strictly for my own enjoyment, and then things seem to just blossom into surprising notice from others. I was very surprised. I'm here today to present a gift to the city of Salinas. It is an oil on canvas painting titled Gateway to the Rodeo, featuring the beautiful sculpture by Klaus Oldenburg called Hats in Three Stages of Flight, of Landing, excuse me. As I've gone through life, I've learned the incredible benefits of gratitude. After a few years of painting for myself, I had accumulated a rather decent inventory of my work. I've always been very involved in the city of Seaside, so as it turned out, it was very fulfilling to gift my work through auctions and different fundraisers for Rotary Community Partnership for Youth and the Boys and Girls Club, as well as for when I was managing Dave Pacheco's campaign for city council. Salinas City Councilman McShane has been a fan of my work, and when we talked about the sculpture in Sherwood Park, I was captivated by both the contrast and motion expressed in Mr. Oldenburg's work and felt the challenge of painting something that famous. It was a challenge, but it was also daunting. I do hope Mr. Oldenburg would be pleased. The park is beautiful, and the connection to the rodeo grounds makes it so special. So I embarked on a mission to create all 6 feet by 4 feet of Gateway to the Rodeo. I am hopeful that I succeeded. I'm here today to present this oil on canvas as a gift to the city. It was recently recognized by the Arts Council of Monterey County and will actually be a part of a special display in the near future before becoming a part of the city's permanent art collection. Of course, that is if you accept it today. Thank you so much for having me here and even considering this. I believe we have some of the brochures from the dedication of the painting to share with you, and I also brought some of my personal art cards. I'm happy to answer any questions you may have. Thank you.
Thank you. Any questions from the council? Seeing none, I just have a comment, which is you're a true inspiration, I think, you know, to start painting at such, you know, at later in your career and mm-hmm. so on, and to do something so impressive, and what a generous thing to offer it to the city of Salinas.
Thank you very, very much. I'm honored. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ashley, thank you. Thank you so much for your donation. I do have a question. I was reading the acceptance from the Public Arts Commission, and I just wanted to, maybe it's just my curiosity, but I also wanted to ask about, do you price your artwork prior to donating to the city?
Do I price my artwork prior to donating it to the city?
Yes.
I typically have an idea, but I started out by not pricing it at all. But as I've gotten into it further, I typically have an idea so that it will move along, especially for the fundraisers.
Okay. Thank you so much. Mm-hmm.
Yes, please. I wanted to thank you. I was lucky enough that I was part of the... When Mr. Klaus Alterman was here several years ago, I was lucky enough to see him. So he came to visit the repainting of the huts. And one of the missions was to inspire art. And I guess if he hears, if he knows that you paint because you're getting inspired by his art, that was his mission. And I think he will be happy to hear that his work inspired you to.
I hope so. I actually worried about that quite a bit, that I would do his work justice, because that's really something.
Yeah, when he came, he was, we have a festival at the park, and we invited local artists, and he was very in love with the community to see that different art forms got mm-hmm. inspired by his.
Wonderful.
The hat of the Stage of Landing. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, very good. So the recommendation is that we accept the Gail Tier Art Donation Gateway to the Rodeo and recommend to the City Council that it be added to the Municipal Art Collection. So at this point, I would look for a first. Anybody like to make a motion?
Yes, I'd like to first second.
Okay, very good. And a second, please?
I second the motion.
Thank you. Any comments or questions before I call for the question? Okay, very good.
Okay, I'm honored. Thank you.
Thank you.
You want to call?
Chairman Andrews?
Aye.
Commissioner Salvador?
Aye.
Commissioner Gonzalez?
Aye.
Commissioner Tenayo?
Aye.
Yes.
But a round of applause.
Congratulations. And thank you, Councilmember McShane, for commissioning the work and for your support of arts in the city of Salinas. Okay. This is a fun meeting. Okay, on to the annual public art plan.
Good evening, Public Arts Commission, Commissioner Bailey. My name is Jose Arriola. I am the Community Safety Administrator, and I've had the pleasure of working with a committee of the Public Art Commission on working on the annual public art plan. Now, on the creation of the commission, we as a commission must submit an annual plan to the Salinas City Council every year by April 1st of 2022. That plan must make a recommendation of potential spending of the public art fund that was created at the time of the creation of this commission. And so this committee has been working diligently for the last couple of months to come up with a draft proposal that you'll hear tonight and that we'll have an opportunity to discuss and recommend some comments or changes or praise, however you'd like to proceed, commission. And then we will take that information and come up with a final draft for you to review at our next full Public Art Commission meeting. Now, the members of this committee who volunteered at our prior meeting are Commissioners Bailey, Cortez, and House. Thank you again for your dedication on this work and showing up to those many lunchtime meetings we had. We had a total of three on September 27th, October 13th, and November 4th. And so we're developing a public arts plan that will look a lot like a staff report that will go to the City Council. And by statute, it has to go no later than April 1st of 2022, which is why we've started so early. And since we only meet about quarterly, we wanted to make sure we had time to review a draft and then a final draft before we prepared something that would go to the City Council. We had a lot of potential ideas, and just a reminder, we had to consider the current fund balance of $10,911.45. And I think we've all learned over the last year that this is not a fund that grows very quickly. It was a year ago at about 5,000. So we've added another five. Chances are we'll add another five or six this next year. And that's not guaranteed. If you remember, it's 0.05% of CIP projects. That build city, they're city CIP projects, so they're not all CIP projects at the city. They have to be specifically out of city funds. And so the more we build, the more we make eventually. And so we had to consider how much to spend and what impact could we have with that particular spending. And we had a lot of ideas that we threw around. Curating an exhibition of existing art. The city does own a lot of art. A lot of it is in storage. And, you know, the more art you have, the more investment you have to make in maintaining. And then also exhibiting art can be costly as well. So we thought maybe we'll use some of the funds to get some of that art out and exhibited. Placemaking with an Alisal mural. So something that would really highlight the Alisal, much like the beautiful Salinas sign that's gone up down here on Main Street. There's a lot to be said for placemaking and the pride that inspires in an area. And we thought about, what if we did something like that in the Alisal? create a grant matching program for arts organizations, or create a new local arts festival. These are all ideas we were talking about, the pros and cons. So ultimately, we landed on these ideas, and this is what I'm presenting to you today on behalf of the committee. So we'd like to request authorization from the City Council to do about $6,000 in spending for fiscal year 22-23, and to not exceed that amount. So it doesn't mean we would spend the whole six, but we'd like authorization to spend up to the $6,000. $5,000 of that would go to support new or existing cultural performing arts events in Salinas by offering a matching grant. An in-kind match would be allowed as well, of up to $2,500. I think everybody on the committee really got excited about giving events an opportunity to highlight artists here in Salinas, because there are so many, and that might have a broad impact to bring the public together around art and create a new platform for artists. And so offering that support might give agencies, organizations an opportunity to either grow their event or start one for the first time. And so the committee got really excited about that idea. And then $1,000 would be used for marketing the Public Art Commission meetings, the master plan projects, like the grant project, vacant commissioner seats, and the grant opportunity. And so these were the key ideas that we'd like to present in a potential plan to the City Council, and that are offering to you for discussion tonight. If you don't love these ideas, we encourage you to speak up and as part of the discussion or offer counter ideas at this time. So just wanted to go to the immediate next steps first, so you guys kind of know the timeline we're on. So the discussion of the proposed plan is happening tonight. The committee will then reconvene based on the information we hear tonight to update the plan accordingly, sometime in between now and the next meeting. So that would be this month, December or January. And then prepare a final draft that will come to this commission in February to get the final blessing. And then we would prepare that for council, hopefully in March, ahead of the April 1st deadline. And that's this particular timeline. We would draft the Public Art Commission plan, final draft in February, and then final to council. The ideal date would be March 22nd. We would take this to the City Council meeting. So at this time, I'd like to invite discussion of the proposed plan and any questions. So I'm restating this particular slide on the public arts plan. And of course, any of the committee members, through the comments and questions, please chime in if you feel I missed anything in this presentation. And again, it's been a pleasure working with all of you.
So, responses from those of you who weren't part of the committee.
I think this is exciting. It's exciting to see that we have this type of support for folks in the community. Thank you for the commissioners who volunteered for that. Thank you, Jose. I'm excited.
Good, JC.
Very much. Jose, thank you so much for preparing your report and for commissioners for working on this development of ideas. I do have questions. I think it was in your page for ideas, potential ideas, and just wanted to... I grew up in Salinas, and I've been somehow connected with the community of arts. And I know that there's a lot of need for organizations to build stronger relationships with the city when it comes to grant matching grants. But I know that the city commissioned an artist named Juan Pozos to do mural work at the Bread Box. And that project is still pending. And I know, and I see that in your list of ideas, you have like the Artisan Vibrancy. And I think that this project with Juan and the artists is very perfectly aligned with what the Artisan Vibrancy plan is, which is the people and the Artisan Vibrancy in the Artisan wanted to vote on what they wanted to see in the mural. And I personally went to that meeting and I saw the energy and the commitment that people have to make these things happen. And I think we're very close to finalize that project, and I would like to see in the near future if part of this update on April can be that part of finalizing projects that have already started. So that project started in, was already approved by the city in late December 2019. Last time that I recall Juan making some kind of conversation with the city was like a few weeks ago. So I think that we're very close to finalize this project. And I think if we are able to come together to finalize this project, I think we can have a win with with Building Healthy Communities, which was part of the involvement in this project. And this is what the people in the Arizal wanted to see. And like I said, I think we can have a big win if we finalize this project before starting new ones. I also know that the California Arts Council for the state has a matching grant, and you can, 10,000, you can match another grant where you can use those 10,000. And unfortunately, I think the deadline already passed, but I know that that's one grant that I think you could use as part of your report. I think that that we already spent like about $50,000, about 50,000, maybe it's not the right amount with the coming with the master plan. So I know that community are gonna be asking about, you know, what happened. And then my other question is around whether more relevant updates to the master plan will need additional cost. And you know, just, I think those are my questions.
A lot of questions in there.
So, one of them is to include a follow-up of the Arizal Vibrancy Mural, which was partly commissioned by the city, and that was in 2019, late December 2019, and it's been on hold for a while. And my recommendations were to, once we follow up that project and finalize it, we can have a win situation for the community and for the city to move forward with more projects that can be funded. And my other recommendation was to look into the grant calendar for the California state where you can match funding that you have. And I personally can volunteer myself to look at grants that we can potentially match.
So I didn't hear, the question is to for an update at a future meeting on that particular project. I will say they are, it's separate parts of the city sort of doing the management of these grant projects. So the Arizal Vibrancy Plan art projects are actually being managed through the Community Development Department in partnership with the Library Community Services Department, because we manage the building it's gonna go on. And yes, COVID did put a stop to that project, unfortunately, but we are hoping to bring it back soon and quickly because we're eager to get that mural up. And I made a note of providing an update at a future meeting.
So am I understanding that you're suggesting that we put the funding we have, or that we consider as a group, putting the funding we have here, we apply it to that project? Is that what I'm understanding?
No. What I said is looking at what you want to present for this proposal, you look at, and one of the ideas was to visit the Arizal Vibrancy Plan or something like that. And I just wanted to remind the commissioners that a project was already been invested in, which is local artists from that area to create murals, and that project was put on hold because the city was trying to figure out what kind of procedures they wanted to do in regards to COVID.
Yeah.
But I wanted to remind the commissioners that that project was something that the residents of the Arizal Vibrancy went and vote on. And there were at least 10 workshops that were already made. So that way that final design that you see in the proposal and the agreement is the final. So I've been in constant communication with the artists because they're community artists, and I mentor several of them. And like I said, I think that it will be a win situation once we finish one project. But I'm not suggesting to put the money that we have.
Okay.
Because what I suggest is like to look at the calendar of the state and the Arts Council, and they can make a calendar that we can share, that some of us would like to volunteer. And I said I can volunteer myself to look at the grant calendar so that way we can apply.
Yes.
That was mostly my recommendation, not to use the current funds that we have.
Okay. I just wanted clarity.
And
there.
That was just recommendation to include.
But that might fit into that as we're talking about that, the marketing of these different things, that might fit really nicely into that project, and that, you know, things that are already happening, that we would use money to tell that story and make sure everybody knows about it.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay, other thoughts, questions, or comments?
I just have a question. Is the city allocating more money in different projects for art projects? The city allocating money for art projects in the different programs?
There are. So as Commissioner Gonzalez was saying, the LaSalle Vibrancy Plan funding, so there was about $3 million allocated in funding to community development for managing. And there are a lot of suggestions in the LaSalle Vibrancy Plan for art pieces to go in. For example, the art piece at the Bread Box that Commissioner Gonzalez is speaking to is funded by community development. And that was older funding. That's funding from like 2019. So this new funding in 2021 potentially will fund some programs. And then in my director's report, I'll be talking about the neighborhood beautification grant, which is about $56,000. And there are multiple art projects that were proposed in the grants, that in the grant applications that we received. So likely a variety of art projects will be funded through that as well. In addition, the public art, the trash corral paintings happening downtown are funded out of the Library Community Services Department out of additional extra funding we set aside during the COVID year because of the shutdown of programming.
Okay, so we have some allocation for the LaSalle Vibrancy Plan, but what about for the whole city? Is that like the master plan? Is the number, or is there a number, is a specific amount that is already allocated for arts fundings in our city?
No, I wouldn't say there's a steady line just designated for art. The LaSalle Vibrancy Plan funding of $3 million, I know there's a specific line item of art, but that'll last maybe a year or two as they complete those projects. There's not, aside from the Public Art Commission fund that we're talking about today for the plan, there's not a designated line year after year for public art funding.
Yeah. And I think my last question will be, is a way that we can, or like request some funding, more funding for our arts commission in order to distribute grants or continue our programs?
I think you could always recommend to council to increase the amount that's allocated to the public art fund,
mm-hmm.
Because that is kind of the designated funding for public art. The other way to go about it would be to propose specific projects. And those could be funded through a variety of different ways. I think that's kind of the purpose of the plan, is to maybe pull out some, you know, another way to look at our public art plan is to say, hey, we're really excited about this project and we want to see how we get it funded. Currently our fund doesn't allow for it. Council, could we put in $2,000 from the fund, and council, could you find another $5,000 to help us make this particular project happen? But you know, the only way to get a consistent amount year after year is to use the mechanism we already have, and that would be to ask council to increase the amount in the actual designation for the Arts Council or the Arts Commission.
Thank you.
I think maybe one of the things we could recommend is that this council be at least a clearinghouse where we know and can communicate out about all the different projects that are happening, whether they are coming from our funding or not, if they're coming through the city's funding, whatever that is, so that there's a primary marketing arm, if you will, for the things that are happening in the arts, because you're talking about something that's exciting. You know, there are these projects that may get funded that aren't funded through us, and then we don't know about them necessarily, and I think we should be a knowledgeable source for the things that are happening within the city regarding arts.
Yeah.
Does that sound like a recommendation we could make?
Yes.
As part of this plan, I know one is about funding, but in addition to that, I think consolidating that information at least with this council would be really, helpful to the community.
I appreciate that, Commissioner Bailey. I think we're trying to move in that direction. Mm-hmm. This commission's relatively new, and we've got a strong commission right now that's meeting relatively regularly, and so we'll do our best to continue to do that. And you'll see with the next presentation, that's exactly what we're trying to do.
Great. Thank you.
I have a question. Who authorized the expenditure, because there's no programming due to COVID, who authorized the expenditure to do that, the art in downtown?
The LCS director did, Library Community Services director. So it was additional funding that we had that would have gone unspent and back into the general fund had it not been spent.
Okay.
And that was unforeseen because of the closures.
Okay. Well, I think, yes, I just have some questions, just because some, you know, funds being shifted from one place to another. When it comes to the arts, I think it should be brought up to the commission because there are a lot of other arts programmings in need, a lot of other organizations, and I wish I would have knew about that because I would have addressed it because we are very closely in contact with the community and we know what the needs are. And I think that there could have been other ways that we could have utilized those particular funding that may have been a little bit, I would say, more beneficial to our community. Not that isn't beneficial, it is needed, but I definitely would like to bring that up at some point where if those type of decisions are being made, we should be notified.
I appreciate that, Commissioner Tamayo. We did bring that presentation here when the idea first came up, and we presented that to the commission before we launched it. So we do try to bring it to the commission ahead of time.
Thank you.
So back to this actual proposal, are there things that you all would suggest that the committee actually take on, we go back and reconsider, or are you happy with it as it is? Because I think we need some direction about how to move forward before goes to the city council. It's a pretty simple plan because there aren't a lot of dollars associated with it. So
That's
we tried
right.
to keep it simple so that we could do some good with the few resources we had. Yeah.
My only additional comment will be, I know there are a lot of grants in there that we can apply. It's just, it's a specific, like, are we planning to do it? And there's time allocated to apply to grants in this plan, or that comes in a different document? I would like to see that applying to grants is part of the plan, but it say it, but doesn't say, you know, doesn't allocate hours, or we need to apply to a couple grants. That's my only concern, that I don't see direct object timelines for applying to grants.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Jose, I have a question. So this is, the proposed is the beautification grant. Is that something that is being proposed or?
The what grant, Commissioner Gonzalez?
The beautification grant.
He's talking about the LSL Vibrancy plan here that we haven't. That's the next presentation.
Yes, that's not this presentation.
So we just mostly talking about what the annual committee presented and what their suggestions were that we can take on. Oh, okay.
Mrs. Moraz, can you put the plan back up, please? Thank you.
So I was, if you don't mind, I have short-term memory, sorry, but I...
There you go.
But I know that, yeah, so that, like, the request for not to exceed 6,000 spending, I think it's a great idea because that way we want to have something that we can use and utilize. But I also feel that at the same time, we have to make a plan on how to double that or get another source of income. And then when it comes to, like, the ideas of creating another event, I feel like there's already a lot of events in the city that are quite successful, and but I wonder if there's an opportunity to talk to them, like the Food and Wine Festival. I think that could benefit from having more arts-related venue that is just dedicated to the arts. And I think that that if the city can come to the table when it comes to those projects that bring a lot of revenue, and they can be a percentage out of the sales of the event, you know, that people want to come to the arts, and then, you know, just really making a plan for something to happen where, like, the funds that we have right now that are well used, it's not a lot of money, it's 10,000, but then if you apply to the Arts Council for a community project that can, you know, help us, and I think that will be part of something that we can take on, just knowing the deadline so that way we can take action, right? Like, the commissioners want to volunteer. But that's a great idea, I think.
I was just speaking, again, like Commissioner House, to maximizing the funding by leveraging it with other grant opportunities.
Yes.
I have a question. Is it possible for, like, a commission or a department to fundraise for these? Like, for example, if we do, like, a fundraising drive, I'd be more than happy to assist or help in regards to a particular project, or is that, like, something that is that possible, basically, is my question. Would it be possible if we decided on a particular, whether it be an event or a project, if we voted and we authorized it, and if it's we get a matching grant, but is there a possibility for fundraising?
So I don't know the exact answer to that. I have to check with the city attorney. My guess is probably not. The city, for example, if we were to apply for a grant, I don't know that the commission as a body could apply. It would be the city of Salinas applying on behalf of the commission. So because we would probably, you know, usually when you apply to a grant, they need to have a responsible body. And the bodies like the commission, I don't think are eligible for that kind of funding. So I'd have to also check with the city attorney if that's something they allow their commissions to do. To my knowledge, it's not, but I'd double check with him to understand that better.
To add to that, though, there may be an opportunity for us, again, with our marketing opportunity to showcase something that's happening where somebody could donate to a particular project, right? The development, so it's not coming to the city, it's not coming to the commission, but it's going to the project that maybe we are supporting in some way.
Sure.
Which is a little bit different. We're not receiving the money.
If we were promoting a project,
So remember that we are not a 501c3 here, so there are grant opportunities that we are not eligible for as a government entity, so they are different, and the tax issues can be different for people who donate to a government body versus a nonprofit 501c3. Yeah. Okay, so I heard mostly that we want to see how we can leverage.
Yes, that's the biggest
this
change
money
I've
to
noted.
Make more money, that's what I'm hearing. So we need to go back to the drawing board on that, I think. Is there anything else that we didn't discuss that the task force or the committee needs to be thinking about? Okay, I think we're good.
All right, thank you, commissioners.
And will you be in touch with the committee then to put together another meeting?
I will.
Okay.
I will send out a doodle poll, and we'll get us together again in the next month.
Great. Thank mm-hmm. you. Okay. Back to the agenda. And so now we have the LSL Vibrancy Plan, Caltrans grant opportunity to beautify 3 underpasses in the LSL. So welcome.
Good evening, commissioners and Chairperson Bailey. Sorry about that. My name is Oscar Resendiz. I'm an associate planner with Advanced Planning and Project and Plan Implementation. And I'm one of the staff members leading the implementation of the LSL Vibrancy Plan. So we recently did a presentation to council as well as met with the implementation committee regarding the next steps for the LSL Vibrancy Plan. And one of the things is district identity and beautification efforts. Some of the ideas with that with those efforts is creating a district identity with implementation of facade improvements, banners, signs similar to what's in downtown, as well as murals. As Jose mentioned earlier, council did approve a $3 million budget, which is great, a great amount, but it's not sufficient to completely implement the LSL Vibrancy Plan. So we have looked for other avenues, and this one just actually happened to fall on our laps that week that we did the presentation, which is the Clean California Beautification Program through Caltrans. We're working with Corby Kilmer, who's a landscape architect that works with Caltrans. And the recommendation was to beautify the 3 underpasses in the Alisal, which is the one on Sanborn, the one on East Alisal, and the one on East Market Street. This is a non-competitive grant. I believe it's a little over $1 million to beautify those 3 underpasses. It could be with murals, it could be lighting, it could be different elements, concrete images, metal images, as well as landscaping in the surroundings. However, there is a requirement is this for the city to maintain after the projects are completed to maintain those projects there. There's a couple of deadlines. We made the first deadline, which was October 15, which was submittal of a draft, basically that we were interested in this grant, and that was submitted by Ms. Kilmer. The next deadline would be November 30th, and is that we are moving forward with the projects. And so another thing that Ms. Kilmer has informed us is that it is community driven, this grant, which she liked the LSL Vibrancy Plan, as well as the Master Sign Plan, Master Parks, and the effort that we've done through vetting it through the community. Here again, like I mentioned earlier, some examples of what could be done in those 3 underpasses, which is top corner right, it could be, and those are images that we've used in community meetings that we've had, using the metal. Middle one is concrete stamps, and other one is incorporating some landscape and lighting, as well as the bottom 3 pictures show lighting. Those are all images from other cities that we were able to grab, and some of them are some that Ms. Kilmer shared with us. And then there is the mural aspect, adding murals. As you all know, the East Alisal underpass already has murals, so we could definitely retouch that and expand with those murals all the way to cover the border, like the example that the bottom picture, left bottom picture has. We have conducted a couple of community outreach pop-ups. The first one we did was at Sherwood Park at October 30th, Halloween event, where we got the input of the community of what they would like to see, whether it's murals, whether it's lighting, and other elements. The second one was at Natividad Park on November 2nd for Dia de los Muertos procession that happened there. And then this last one just happened this Saturday at Carr Lake, the resource fair. Again, getting as much feedback as we could from the community. And our outreach assistants have also gone to some of the elementaries after school to get the parents as well as the students, because everyone that lives in the Jalisal, whether you're an 8-year-old to an older person, could put their input and their ideas that they would like to see in their community. From those, some of the feedback that we've gotten from the pop-ups have been that they're interested in murals and lighting. Some of them have said, you know, murals that are bright in color, and the murals keep people from placing graffiti. As we could see with the East Alisal underpass, the murals are intact, and there are, after the murals, some patches that they have to repaint because people have graffiti. But I think there's this community respects the murals, so it would definitely help. Remember this gentleman that is a trucker and has gone to Alabama. He says that there's a lot of underpasses with a lot of lighting. So he says he would like that in the underpasses just because it gives a sense of safety and security. And so what we ask from the Public Art Commission is a stakeholder group, as well as to connect us more with the arts community, muralists, and local artists. Because again, the next step with this grant is submitting a proposed project by the end of this month. And then we would be notified if we got the award January, February. And then April of 2022 is when we have to present an actual, like the murals or the lighting plan. And we have until June 30th of 2023 to complete them. So it is a pretty fast program completion. And yeah, we're here for that here, as well as we would come at later commission meetings with the murals for your suggestions, recommendations. And that concludes my presentation. Thank you very much. And I'm open to any questions that you might have.
I don't have any questions, but it's just something that I'd like for the commission to really take into consideration in our responsibility to our community. I have experience. I was been part of the Alisal Vibrancy Plan in the creation of it, in the process. Also attended many meetings in regards to the mural that is to go up at the Breadbox. And we really have to be very conscientious of the decisions that we make and who's making the decisions. My experience was that the community chose a particular design of a mural, and that's not what's going to be presented on that mural. Speaking with the artist himself and being part of the process of the artist developing that mural, it was very challenging for him after he created several pieces and the community voted on those pieces. However, he's still not allowed to put what the community asked for. So I think it's very important for us to be part of that process and really commit to what the community wants. I just want to take that, make sure that we all take that into consideration. I really love what the work and the research that you've done, the whole process. But I mean, that's one of the reasons why I'm on this commission, because there needs to be a paradigm shift in the way that decisions are made. And I'm very committed to this community, and I want to make sure that their voice and what they ask for is heard. So thank you.
I know you're going to say something.
Thank you so much for your report. I do have questions about your deadline for the 30th of this month. What is that deadline for?
It's just a bit of final draft of the ideas that we would like to use this funding for. The funding is a little over $1 million to beautify those three underpasses. Having a couple of meetings with Corby, who is a landscape architect that works for Caltrans, she's mentioned that we could either use the $3 million the million to split it on the three underpasses, or concentrate more on two of the underpasses and a little less on the other underpass. So we have, like I said, done the pop-ups. Definitely community driven. We definitely want the community's input, and we want to honor, as Commissioner Tamayo said, what they would like to see in the community. And it's not something that we would present, and that's why we're getting the feedback. You might not be able to see, but some of the pictures that we've used as ideas that we got from the internet from other cities. And what we're telling them is, you know, it's just ideas of what you would like. There would definitely be follow-up, either pop-ups or community meetings, as well as with the implementation committee of design. Another thing that we seek here with you guys is connecting us even more with the local artists, so they could also get an opportunity to submit their art, what they would like to see there. And we have talked to Juan, you mentioned earlier, he did reach out to Monica, and I need to reach back out to him regarding his project that he has there. Unfortunately, COVID hit and we had to put a stop, but now, hopefully, you know, COVID is getting a little more stable and we can move forward with the projects that we had in mind before COVID hit.
Thank you. I also have questions. So what kind of support do you would like from us? Are you looking for us to look at what you have as an investment in the arts and, you know, because that way, I think that's something that you can submit that can speak also to the artist. You can also, you know, we can support that if we have access to what you can present. And I think, I mean, what I'm saying is like, you know, like following what the already community wanted to see, but that way we can support what they want, right? And whether it is that, like you said, I don't know, I think it's $1 million, but if you really think about it, like Salinas with the downtown expansion and everything else, the prices are still going to be fine, but I think there has to be a strong investment in arts, in visual arts, performing arts. And I think that there's just a lot of organizations that will be willing to be part of that, but I think there has to be a way for them to come together.
Yeah, definitely. I think what we're here for is for your support in that sense of reaching out to the community, that the artistic community, to give them an opportunity, like I mentioned earlier. One of the ideas, and also using the Frida mural that has been created and is just waiting for a home to be placed. We've also vetted with Corvius if we could have murals, and not necessarily in the one on East Alisal underpass, but on the other ones where we could... they could be movable, giving the opportunity for more artists to showcase their art and not having just one mural vetted. So that's one thing that we are looking in this commission is for that assistance with the art community.
So you would like people us to point people towards you?
Yes.
And yes. Before November 30th?
Not necessarily before November 30th. Well, it is a good idea to start the process. We don't actually need to present the actual mural by the 30th. But soon after, we'll start again re-engaging and setting up those meetings, as well as the process of submittal to be selected for a mural or the murals.
I'm a little, just want a clarification. Is the mural is going to be under the bridge or the support for the opportunity to beautify three underpasses in the Alisal is a different team?
So it's the murals or lighting, which is what the community, the feedback that we've gotten back mostly, then the decorative concrete or metal is to cover the underpass, and it could also be, you know, the front as you're entering into the underpass, like similar to what you see in picture bottom left corner where it's on the top of the underpass. So it could be the whole face of the underpass as well as within the underpass as it is currently in the East Alisal.
Is there like a budget or how much, like comparison, how much will cost the lighting plus the mural, or use only the mural that people can also see?
Yeah, so again, the grant is for a little over $1 million, and we would have to come up with the cost for either lighting, the mural, and make it work for either all three of the underpasses or concentrating on two of the underpasses and a little less on the other one, or just concentrating on one and not the less. Ideally, we would like to use it on all three of them.
So are the artists are going to be paid as part of the grant budget?
Yeah. I mean, we would have that grant to pay the artists to showcase their art. Definitely we would be using that grant for it.
So what qualifications do you need from the person?
Unfortunately, we're not up to that step right now of the qualifications. Again, I think that's something that we're here for your support on. If there's a list of artists that you guys have, and we have worked with some, Juan being one of them, that we have, but mostly for that, or if there's other artists that are not part of any groups that you guys might know, students maybe.
And how do they reach you? What is your contact information?
Contact information could be my email address. It's oscarr@ci.salinas.ca.us. My direct line, and unfortunately, I don't know it by heart, but I'll give it to you right now in a split second.
Question. So in this process, you'd like us to recommend artists. We have a very extensive list, hundreds of artists. I think what might be a helpful tool is maybe like a questionnaire, like a maybe proposal type, because I think just recommending an artist and having them email you, I think it might make it challenging. So maybe like a questionnaire or a proposal type, something that I can provide for the artist so that they can either submit, for example, their portfolio or something in particular, or past work or murals. So I think that process would kind of, it'd be more appropriate, because if they just email you, I think that we need a little bit more guidance.
No, definitely. There would be a process that they would need to submit, whether it's an application, a portfolio mm-hmm. of what they've done, whether it's here or in other cities. Mm-hmm. Just that you guys were asking how to contact me.
Oh, okay.
That's why I'm giving that information. But mm-hmm. yeah, there would definitely be a process on so everyone has an opportunity and it's not just the 3-4 artists that communicate with me.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, and, I would like to recommend to contact the Arts Council and Eric, volunteer. The Arts Council, they have an amazing database of Salinas local artists. Mm-hmm. And they also have people that apply to their grants, and I would recommend just connect them. The Arts Council have an amazing connection with the community as well, and they might be able to help to outreach our local artists as well.
Okay, thank you. And then just for my number is 831-775-4259. That's my direct line. I do tell everyone that I services that I try to return the call within the same day, if not within 24 hours, if they leave me a message.
775-4259. Okay. Thank you very much for the presentation. This is an exciting project.
Yes.
Nice to see that something's happening in the city of Salinas. Very good.
Yes. Yeah, thank you. We're excited to see all the prospect on this.
Yes,
in the future.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you
so much.
Appreciate it.
So we're running long tonight, but I wanted to make sure that we have chance for commissioners' reports. So I'll start down with you, Commissioner House, if you have anything to report, and we'll go down this way this time.
I don't have anything to report more than wish you happy Thanksgiving and happy holidays if we don't see each other. And thank you so much for your service. And I hope you guys can make it to the next art plan updates. Or if you have any questions, just let us know so we can add your comments or feedbacks to our next meeting. Thank you.
No, I don't have any current reports today.
Okay. Very good. I just want to encourage everybody to, as they think about holiday gifts, again, to support the arts. It's a wonderful way to give something unique and to support local artists. And you don't have to worry about something being on a ship out in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. So you can get it right here locally. So please support the artists in that way. Okay, very good.
Thank you, everyone. I've been working with community-based artists. I grew up in Salinas myself, and about 2016 we were housed here right in front of the women's club, and so I had the experience of being here and there, and we finally signed a space with the Moongate Plaza in Chinatown, and Urban Arts Collaborative have a space gallery that we use for teaching our visual arts and also doing gallery work and curatorial practices. And it's very exciting. I think I didn't know how it was in Chinatown until I start going there more often. It's very exciting. So I think that part of the arts is revitalizing Chinatown.
Wonderful. Okay, and a director's report.
Thank you, Chair Bailey. My name is Jose Arriola. I'm the Community Safety Administrator, and I have the pleasure of sitting in for Library Community Services Director Kristen Lundquist, who wanted to be here today but couldn't unexpectedly. And she did leave me some report outs. And I just want to say that I've heard certainly in my work with the committee and just from the commission over the last couple of meetings that you guys really want to get to the work, and we're doing our best. And I know Director Lundquist is committed to bringing as much, any of the fragmented sort of arts projects happening across the city to the commission as we can early and often. So you guys, as Commissioner Tamayo was saying, get an opportunity to weigh in, right, on equitable distribution of arts and how we're spending, those sorts of things. We'll do our best to get those out in front of you guys early and often. And to that end, we have the neighborhood beautification grants, which we found of the 25 applications we received, over $190,000 in project asks for an available $56,000 of funding. Nearly half of those projects are arts projects. And think of that half, two-thirds of them are mural projects. And so we'd like to schedule a special meeting in January to bring you guys together to see those potential projects. By then, we'll know which ones were selected by City Council for funding, and we'll bring those here for you guys to weigh in, to see the designs, to discuss them, but also to see if they meet the basic needs of what a public art mural needs to be in the city of Salinas. We'll talk more about that later. And so I'll just let you know, we'll be sending out a doodle poll. Ms. Mraz will be helping with that, and you'll hear from us about a potential date in January. Just to give you a heads up, we're not deciding anything. We got to run it by the city clerk, but we're looking at January 10th or the 19th. We can't pick our normal third Monday of the month. I think it's Martin Luther King's birthday, and so our cities are generally closed at that date. But that will come to all of you. And so just an update, huge response for the neighborhood beautification grant. The Frida mural that you saw earlier that was presented, that mural, it was a neighborhood beautification grant funded mural. And so it needs to find a home. It was a movable mural, so we can have it in different locations. So we're really excited about that. And so that's my update and my report for the director.
Thank you. All right, if there's nothing else, we did go long. I want to thank everybody who participated in the meeting. I want to thank all the commissioners for good questions and comments and thoughts. I want to thank you, Jose, and you, Patricia, and thank everybody here. And with that, I close this meeting. Thank you. Meeting is adjourned.